now making his way to the ring, and you can see how focused he is for the task at hand. Here's the first. And now they're opening up. Both right hands land. His defense is now serving him well. Nice job blocking that punch. Nice work with the uppercut. Rusher's combination punching is working well here. Takes a step back. And the counterpunch by Crusher.
Very similar to what you see Floyd Mayweather do. You know, make a miss, pull that shoulder back, and then come right back with the counter.
Keeping his hands up, getting rid of his opponent's offense. Good work right there, landing the two punches in sequence by Ruiz. Well, he goes to the gut with a right hand. Rock'em, sock'em robots right from the start here, Teddy.
No defense, just pure offense.
Very nice work to the head. The right hand landed. Needs to improve that accuracy. Missed with the headshot. Oh, and the right hand comes into play by Crusher. Coming to the end of this round, Joe and Teddy with you ringside. Teddy, a round like that where it's a lot of busy activity and both guys being busy. When you were a trainer, are those the kind of rounds that you prefer, or do you like the pace to be a little slower? Does it depend on each guy?
No, if I have a fighter, I'd rather have a guy fighting a guy that you never see him. Leave me the heck alone. And where I'm in control all the time. But the fans love to see a fight like that.
To the head he goes with a left hand. Right to the body. That's a good probing jab that time by Crusher.
Inside, inside!
Solid uppercut. That is a big right hand after eating one himself. Right to the belt line. He tried to nab him up top, but was unable to connect. And that's what fighters do. Pulls the trigger right away after taking one. Crusher's hit to the head. He clearly came in with a strategy here tonight, Teddy. And so many times, it's, hey, I'm going to bang that drum.
Yeah, he is banging that drum. That drum happens to be the body. And he figures that he's going to try to move on him, so start doing it early on, and later on, he's going to have a guy in front of him.
A flush hook scores well for him. Very accurate to the body with that left hook. Then he brings the right hand. He returns the favor with a right hand of his own. Just 10 seconds to go here in the second round. Not hitting his mark there, going upstairs. And the bell rings, signifying...
Find a way to get away from some of those punches, but there's a problem, a big problem, like with anything else. How are you going to start changing it if you haven't been taught differently? I don't know that he knows the answer.
I like this. He's not skipping a beat. He came out just the way he finished up last round.
Yeah, what I like is that he's a thinking man fighter, and his corner gave him probably good advice. They know that the opponent only had 60 seconds to recover, and they're figuring it wasn't enough time.
Rusher's just looking to get it done on the back end here, Teddy.
Yeah, he is. He's just waiting to set a trap. You know, he's trying to get his opponent to walk in where he can make a miss, and bang, spring it on.
Ruiz is almost looking foolish that time he missed so badly. A little headhunting with the right. Rusher smacked up top. Nice job there, hooking to the body. Good job zoning in on that body with the left hook. Even better job bringing the right hand in combination. And now he scores well with a straight right. Goes upstairs with a right hand, left hook combination. And just grabbing onto his opponent.
Keep your back off the ropes. Pace yourself.
Rusher's three-punch combination there is going to impress the judges. He scores with the jab there. Well, his opponent is opening up and coming forward, so I would think there are some opportunities that exist.
Yeah, I think some counterpunching opportunities. Opportunities not on the front end, but on the back end.
Super two-punch combo by Crusher. Ruiz is hoping to recover right here. The way to do it, he feels, to tie up.
Yeah, it's not about machoism right now. It's about getting past this point.
Did you see that? Teddy, he goes down, and he was on the outside where he doesn't like to be.
Where he shouldn't be, and he paid a price.
Four, five, six, seven, eight, nine,
let's go, ten.
It's over. This fight is over. Crusher's in prime form. Power surge.